Yeshua certainly pegged it when he said that he would come upon the wicked servant like a thief in the night. It truly is just like it was in the days of Noah, because most of you are fast asleep in your rebellion to our Creator. Nearly all of you who claim that you are being cleansed by His blood are wicked because you trample His shed blood under your feet. Our Creator's word that His Son became in the flesh has no place in your rebellious hearts. You trample His shed blood under your feet by rejecting why He shed it. Jeremiah recorded that the Messiah would shed His blood so that you could enter into a renewed covenant with His Father. If you had received the conditions of this covenant that He brought, His Father's Torah would have been written in your hearts and in your inward parts, just like Jeremiah recorded it would be. But you despise what He spoke about obeying His Father when He came instead. You love to follow the ravening wolves like Saul of Tarsus instead, and all the other false shepherds who take you away from obeying His Torah. Yeshua said in Revelation 3:3, "Remember therefore what you have received and heard, and hold fast to it, and repent. Wherefore, if you are not awake, I will come on you as a thief in the night, and you will not know at what hour I will come upon you." One person actually wrote me yesterday and told me that His blood was shed for the unrepentant sinner. This is insanity to even think something like this. It is amazing what the uncircumcised heart will come up with to give themselves a false sense of eternal security, to believe some nonsense like this. The water that we are baptized in is not turned into Yeshua's blood unless we are repenting. So we're not repenting, we're just being baptized in water, and water doesn't cleanse sin of anything. You need to have it turned into Yeshua's blood, and this is the process of walking in repentance. Repenting is turning from our rebellion to his Father and walking as He walked. He came to set the example, is walking to be found without blemish before our Elohim's face. The other day in the washing in the make-believe blood video, I spoke about how the Japan tsunami was 55 days after the January 15th proclamation. I spoke about how the number 55 is a signature that my Father has used to stamp His hand in this ever since shortly after He sent me to you. He has also used the number 11 throughout this as well. And 11, of course, ties into 55 and everything with the spacing of the trumpets and such for those of you who are following this. In that video the other day where I was talking about the number 55, I mentioned a verse in Isaiah without even connecting it in my mind that the verse that I was quoting was Isaiah 55:11. I thought of it right after I finished the recording. I spoke about verse 10 as well in that video, but verse 10 is just a precursor to verse 11. And of course, man put the chapters and the verses there, but obviously man was inspired at some point in time in this process to number this verse in chapter 55 and 11, because our Creator certainly is in control of everything, whether He allows Satan to do things or whether He actually influences the things Himself and inspires people to do stuff. So anyway, Isaiah 55 says, to start off in verse 10, He says, "In the manner that the rain and the snow will fall from heaven and water the earth, and before they return, they cause it to bring forth and bud, so that they may give seed to the sower and bread to the eater." So saying in the same manner, verse 11, "So will my word," He says, "be that proceeds forth out of my mouth. It will not return to me void. It will accomplish that which I purpose, and it will prosper in that what I sent it to do." He sent it to mold and fashion us in His image. His word testifies to this. If you go back and listen to the over 400 videos that I've posted on the site since 2010, you will find that what He has sent me to proclaim is all about this verse. The reason why we are here is all about the reason why He gave us His word, which is to mold us in His image as we walk before His face in His word, walking in His word. The word Torah means a pathway. Yeshua said in John chapter 14, verse 6, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man can come to my Father except through me," or through the path of me, as walking as He walked. He came bearing His Father's word. He was made to be His Father's word in the flesh. John recorded this plainly. He told Pilate that He was sent to bear witness to the truth, and He said to His disciples the night before He was killed that the truth is His Father's word. It's found in John 17:17. His Father's word is the same word that you in Christianity reject as you follow the abomination of desolation, Saul of Tarsus, instead following His word. You love to trample His word under your feet, and you love to hold fast to your faults saved by grace apart from the works of the Torah doctrines that you have, that you embrace. Most of you even go so far as to call his Torah evil. In doing so, you're calling his son evil because he was his father's Torah in the flesh. And the book of Revelation says that he bears it as his name because it is the name that his father has given to him. Our Creator's Torah is his word because it is in his word. You can't separate them out. You cannot see your hypocrisy because you refuse the eye salve that would give you eyes to see. The eye salve is fearing Yehweh Elohim and fearing to oppose him, but you have no fear. You have no fear of opposing his will for you. Instead, you tell him how it is and how he will give you eternal life and such. Folks, this is so simple. And Yeshua saying that he is the pathway, he was saying that his Father's word that he became in the flesh is the pathway. He said point blank that we have to keep the commandments in order to have eternal life given to us when he was asked. He said point blank that he was not sent to get rid of one punctuation mark from his Father's Torah. Isaiah prophesied that he would magnify the Torah and make it glorious when he was sent. And this is exactly what he did when he came. He taught beautiful magnification of his Father's Torah, like even looking at another who is not your wife is the same thing as committing adultery to her. Pluck out your eye if it causes you to stumble and such, rather than enter into heaven, in the kingdom of heaven, with one eye, rather than not enter into it at all, things like this. And in saying this about the adulterer woman, he precept upon precept in his Father's word also shows that he was saying that looking at another image of him or another image of his Father is the same thing as committing adultery with them. But you are a bunch of whores who have no fear, so you could care less what he said and what his word testifies to. You love your boy Saul's teachings instead. You love sleeping in Satan's bed. You love bearing Satan's name instead of bearing our Elohim's righteousness that his name testifies to, and his word testifies to. You love bearing Satan's mark in your foreheads and in your right hands because you love living in your rebellion to Yahweh's Torah. You love profaning his Sabbaths and you love putting no difference between the clean and the unclean. You boast in your rebellion to Yahweh's word and you boast in washing in the make-believe blood that you wash with. You have no shame for your nakedness and no fear that you are dead before Yahweh's face because you refuse to walk as his son walked. That's the reason why you're dead before his face. And now dying you will die, except for the 3.33% of you who will come down off of your high horses that you're on and turn from your rebellion in humility. True worship in spirit and in truth is walking in agreement with our Creator in his instructions to become as he is. Like his word says, this is why he created us. We are to worship him by making our lives revolve around hearkening to him to become as he is, leaving our lives for his kingdom's sake, like his son said. Everything else is false worship. Our Creator desires for us to become his righteousness because two cannot walk together unless they are agreed. And he's building an eternal family, so he's not going to let that which does not agree with him end this eternal family. That's why we're here in the flesh, to purge out all that does not agree with him. Why he put Satan here and everything's why he gave us free will. All of this is part of him building his family. But you reject the reason why he gave us his word and why he put us here. Therefore, you rejecting why he gave you life. In order to give yourselves a false hope, you worship make-believe images of him and his son to fill the void that he actually created us with. It was used to call those who would become his family to him. You fill that void with lies. Like I said, his word testifies that this makes you a whore before his face. Your worship is in vain as you pursue after the empty and hollow traditions in Christianity that came from your father, the devil. A few videos ago, I said that I will rejoice when the 96.667% of the inhabitants of the world are destroyed in the coming days. I will rejoice because I know that the only way for my Father's will to be done on earth as it is in heaven is for those of you who live in rebellion to his word to be purged from this earth. And of course, Yeshua told us to pray that his Father's will would be done on earth as it is in heaven. So this is actually his will to desire this. And like I said, man was allowed to go their own way as he pulled out his first fruits. I spoke about that in a lot of the videos, but now the first fruits are built, the temple's finished. His prophet Ezekiel recorded this number, this 96.6667%. So it will come to pass. His Feast of First Fruits is just 18 days away now, when he will send his son to accomplish this after he harvests his father's first fruits. The sword that he will be sent with is his father's word, and all will be judged by it, just like he said. All will be judged by his father's word in the last days. The measuring rod that the two witnesses were sent with. The reason that you will be of this number is because his word has no place in your rebellious hearts. You would rather tell him how it is in your arrogant, pride-filled, uncircumcised hearts. You refuse to eat his son's flesh and drink of his blood. You refuse to follow after him by walking as he walked, and you love to profane his name, which is his father's word. You are of your father the devil indeed, and the word of Elohim will come upon you like a thief in the night indeed. The good news is we don't have much longer to wait for your rebellion to him to be purged from before his face. 18 days will pass quickly, and July 19th will be here, and this is certainly good news, because after this, his will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Thus saith Yehovah Elohim.